Welcome to the PowerPoint show for Unit 29. In Unit 29, we'll look at some applications of oxidation reduction, which are some concepts you saw in the last unit. You should, before looking at this section, review sections 8.3 and 8.4 in the textbook to get a better understanding of what you're going to be up to. We're going to look at a couple different things, a couple different topics in here. One is we're going to look at a description of electrochemical cells, probably better known to you as batteries. We're going to look at some electrochemical terminology, anodes, cathodes, things of that nature. Look at, electrochemistry as applied to batteries, and also look at corrosion, because corrosion really is an application of oxidation reduction reactions. We look at electrochemistry overall and think about these reactions I'm showing you in this beaker here. We actually carry out this experiment in our Chem 1 labs. What you have on the left-hand side is a copper wire, and it's in a solution of silver nitrate. Remember, silver nitrate would be Ag, and then NO3 is the nitrate group. So fundamentally, it's really just silver ions and copper metal is inside of that flask. If you let it sit for a little while, you'll come back and you'll find out you have a beaker that looks like the one on the right, which has copper nitrate in it now, actually copper 2 ions, and has silver metal. So if you look at the two elements involved, the primary elements involved are copper and silver. The copper starts out as the element on the left-hand side and ends up in solution over on the right-hand side as copper 2 ions. So the copper has gone from copper metal to copper 2 plus. He's lost 2 electrons. That means he's been oxidized in this process. The silver, on the other hand, started out as silver plus 1 ions in that solution on the left, ends up as silver metal. That's what the kind of the stuff hanging on the copper wire on the right-hand side is. That's silver metal that you formed. Pay attention to the blue color in that solution on the right. We'll mention that in just a second. So, if you look at what we have going on here, what I've just described is written out in color here. The copper 2 ions that are formed on the right-hand side are the ions that form that color in that solution. It's a blue-colored solution because it has copper 2 ions, and the copper metal, copper atoms, which had their full complement of electrons, have given up 2 electrons and gone into solution, and that solution turns blue. If you had copper 1 ions in solution, that solution would actually be green. They have different colors in solution. The silver ions, previously just floating around the solution, now are actually elemental silver, hanging off of the copper in that right-hand beaker. If you put an equation form, the copper as a solid, it starts out as a solid on the left, ends up producing copper 2 ions, which means it's giving up electrons. So the product of that is you get copper 2 ions, and you also give up 2 electrons in that process. The silver, on the other hand, starts out as silver plus 1 ions, picks up an electron and forms silver metal on the other side. And so in electrochemistry, it's fairly important to understand how these two reactions work together. So what we can do, each of the reactions we've written is called a half reaction. One of them tells us about an oxidation, the other tells us about a reduction. Which one's the oxidation? Which one do you think is the oxidation? If you said the top one, you're right. Because in the top one, a couple ways of thinking about it, the copper went from a 0 to a plus 2, so it went up in oxidation number, so that would make it an oxidation. The other thing is, you can tell by looking at the equation, it's giving up electrons, isn't it? It's giving up 2 electrons. That's one of the products in there. Now, in order to take these two reactions and put them together to tell us what's going on in the cell, we have to recognize that our electrons have to be balanced out. So if the copper is going to give up 2 electrons, there has to be some place those 2 electrons can go. And those 2 electrons can't go to one silver, because each silver can only take on 1 electron. So what you see in this process is we have to do some balancing. Back to like balancing equations. We have to balance these things so that our electrons match coming in and going out. And so the next slide we'll take a look at that and see what we can do is think about just multiplying the whole equation by some number to get the electrons to match up. So keep these equations in mind. Copper goes to copper ion and 2 electrons. Silver ion and an electron goes to silver metal. And take a look at this next slide. Okay, so in the top reaction here, I've got the copper metal going to copper ions and 2 electrons. And then the second one down there, I've got silver ions going to picking up an electron and going to silver metal. You notice that what I've done is I've multiplied by 2 in front of that bottom reaction. That's because I have to have as many electrons going into this process as I have coming out. They have to balance out. And the way it's written, if it's written without the two, I have two electrons being given up by copper and only one being taken out by silver. So the way I account for that is to multiply that second equation by two. Okay, and then when I do that, here's what it looks like. I multiply it through. The copper one doesn't really change at all. But now the silver one, everything in the silver gets multiplied by two. Everything. When you're multiplying, it's just like in math. You're multiplying an equation by two. Everybody has to be multiplied by two. There are no favorites. Okay? And so then you get to these two equations. You're going to take and add these two equations together. When you do that, what you find in the bottom, just look at where the arrows are. You can put everybody that's on the left-hand side of the arrow, everybody that's on the right-hand side of the arrow, on the right-hand side of the arrow. You notice that you have two electrons on the left and two electrons on the right, which means you could just skip writing them in there. You can basically cancel them out. Kind of like a math-looking thing, isn't it? You can take and cancel those guys out, and you'll be fine. So my balanced equation is the one at the bottom. Now, if you left the twos out, you'd say, wait a minute, it's still balanced. I still have one copper on each side and one silver on each side. But if you were to do that, you haven't paid attention to the electrons. And so the properly balanced equation is that one at the bottom of the page. Now let's look at electrochemical cells. So the reaction we just saw all went on in one flask. If we could figure out a way of separating those two components from each other, we could actually get those electrons to maybe go through a wire and do something useful for us. And so we can do that by setting up a beaker that looks like this. That yellow thing in the middle is what we call semi-permeable membrane. It only lets some things go through. And what this one lets go through is it lets the solvent go through. It also lets the nitrate ions pass through, those negatively charged nitrate ions. Notice they didn't take place anywhere in the reaction, did they? But what we do in this cell is we allow the nitrate ions to go through that membrane. And what happens in this process, remember that the silver is picking up electrons, isn't it? Okay, so the electrons are going from the copper to the silver. That's the blue arrows at the top. That's a light bulb there that I've drawn without a filament or anything. That's a light bulb. The electrons are going through there. They're lighting my light bulb out. They're going over to the silver. And what happens then is those electrons come into there. Silver ions go over, pick up electrons, and form silver metal. And the nitrate ion passes through to the left-hand side, because if it didn't, the whole thing would go dead. It has to have electrical flow. It has to have like a current flowing through it in the whole time. And so, as you look at that diagram, this really is a way of getting that light bulb to light up. The copper is an electrode. It's like a piece of wire stuck in there. It's called the anode, because that's where the oxidation is occurring. The silver on the right-hand side is called the cathode, because that's where the reduction is occurring.